Welcome back, students. Today we are taking up next topic of chapter solution of class 12th, that is abnormal molar mass. So what is abnormal molar mass? When molecular mass of a substance is determined by studying any of the colligative properties that comes out to be different than the expected value, that substance is said to show abnormal molecular mass. अब ये जो abnormal molar mass है, ये कब appear होता है? You know, when solution is non-ideal. First thing is solution is non-ideal. Second, solute undergoes association or dissociation. Then we have abnormal molar mass. To calculate, see, either association or dissociation. Non-ideal solution means solution is not dilute. Solution is not dilute because colligative properties are applicable for dilute solutions. Either solution is not dilute or solute undergoes association or dissociation. So to calculate the extent of association or dissociation, Van Hoff is a chemist. Van Hoff in 1980 introduced a factor I, and that is called Van Hoff factor. Now what is Van Hoff factor? So Van Hoff factor is defined as ratio of experimental value of the colligative property to the theoretical value of the colligative property, or we can say observed colligative property over calculated colligative property, or it is also defined as abnormal colligative property divided by normal colligative property, or normal molar mass to abnormal molar mass. Now normal molar mass means calculated molar mass, and abnormal molar mass means observed molar mass. So it also defined as MC over MI. Now it can also be defined as number of particles after association or dissociation divided by number of particles before association or dissociation. Now for dissociation, degree of dissociation. So degree of dissociation is defined as number of moles dissociated divided by total number of moles taken. Now take an example, like we have NaCl. So NaCl, when we dissolve it in water, what would we get? We get Na plus and Cl negative in water. So that means what is number of particles before association? If it is 1, then after dissociation it becomes 2, right? Like we have K2SO4. So K2SO4 is dissociated as 2K plus and SO4 2 negative. So what is what are the number of particles, and how many particles are formed? 3. 1 is converted into 3 particles, because you know what is colligative property? It depends upon the number of non-volatile solute particles related to the total number of moles of the solution. So N for NaCl is 2, N for K2SO4 is 3. So let us take a general example in which one particle that gives n. A general example, one particle an is converted into n particles. So let us take this example. Now, before dissociation, we have one particle, so obviously this is zero. Now, after dissociation, let's take an example. Out of one, alpha gets dissociated. Alpha is degree of dissociation. And you know what is degree of dissociation? Just ratio of the number of moles dissociated to the total number of moles taken. Or it is also defined as fraction of the total substance that undergoes dissociation. Right? So, out of 1, alpha gets dissociated. So, what is left? 1 minus alpha. So, if 1 is dissociated, we get n. So, if alpha is dissociated, what would we get? We get n alpha. So now, what is variant of factor? Number of moles after dissociation. So how many moles are there? 1 minus alpha plus n alpha divided by number of moles before dissociation. So it is 1. So that means it is now 1 plus n minus 1 alpha, right? So I is equal to 1 plus n minus 1 alpha. And if alpha is 1, when alpha is 1 means it is completely dissociated, then I comes out to be n. If it is 1, so 1 plus n minus 1, 1 minus 1 cancel, so I is equal to n. For complete dissociation, I is equal to, for complete dissociation, right? For complete dissociation, I is equal to n. So this is for dissociation. And what is alpha? It is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1, right? So these are the expressions for dissociation. Okay, now come to association. In case of association, for association, degree of association, alpha is equal to number of moles associated divided by total number of moles taken. Okay, so in this case, like, you know, acetic acid in non-polar medium, it undergoes association like this. So that means it forms dimer. So what is n for the acetic acid? It is 2 in case of association, because two molecules are associated. If 3 are associated, then n for association is 3. 4, that means tetramerization. This is dimerization. Dimerization means when two molecules joined to give one molecule. If 4 molecules joined, that become tetramerization, and n for that is 4 for tetramerization. For hexamerization, it is 6, right? Now, association. So just reverse, n molecules gives 1. Okay, let us take an example. N is any number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, now before association, n is 1, it is 0. Before association, and after association, again alpha is associated, Now see, if n gets associated, we get 1. If 1 gets associated, we get 1 by n. If alpha gets associated, we get alpha by n. So it is now alpha by n. So what is I now? 1 minus alpha plus alpha by n. Number of moles after association divided by number of moles before association. So I is equal to 1 plus 1 by n minus 1 alpha. So this is one set, and then again alpha is equal to I minus 1 divided by 1 by n minus 1, right? So these are two expressions. And again for 100% association, what is alpha? 1. So I comes out to be 1 by n. That means for dimerization, 100% dimerization, I is equal to 1 by 2. For 100% tetramerization, I equal to 1 by 4. For 100% hexamerization, I is equal to 1 by 6. Thank you very much for watching this video. Okay, yes. If now I is equal to calculated molar mass over observed molar mass. So in terms of calculated or observed molar mass, I is equal to MC over MO minus 1, and 1 by n, it can be written as 1 minus n upon n, means it is n upon 1 minus n, right? Or we can write it as MC minus MO divided by MO into n upon n minus, sorry, if it is n minus 1, it is taken as minus, or we can write it as M observed molar mass minus calculated molar mass divided by observed molar mass into n upon n minus 1. So we can use this term also. Or in case of dissociation, this is the expression for dissociation. So for dissociation, we can write alpha again equal to calculated over observed minus 1 into n minus 1. So it can be written as calculated minus observed calculated, can be written as calculated minus observed over observed into 1 by n minus 1, or we can write calculated minus observed divided by observed into n minus 1. So that's it. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video, and I will do some numericals related to the same topic in my next video. Thank you very much. Keep watching and excel in your exams.